away from the scale, this new product just isn't sitting well, George. We should mention the app is free, but you can pay for coaching, George.
Okay, Paul, thanks very much. We have a new GMA health alert now. Concerned about vaping, as the CDC reports that it's investigating 94 cases of possible lung illnesses related to e-cigarettes.
You didn't get that one?
I didn't get that one.
Hospitalized with severe lung
illness. When it first came on, it was like,
let me get her again.
So tell us, what are we seeing here?
So over the past few weeks, we've seen an increasing number of cases of acute lung injury, severe illness, leading to hospitalizations in teens and young adults linked with e-cigarettes or vaping.
Several times there, huh? That was a long one. Counting,
and some of the people are quite sick. They start out with symptoms like
cough,
fever,
chest
tightness,
no problem, because
he
might take you and then
you'll
look like that.
Some people have actually progressed to needing the intensive care unit and a ventilator to breathe. We're concerned about this because youth e-cigarettes...
Maybe somebody else might know and got that last one.
There's no question about that, but there's no problem.
Where's she, Mama?
What is it about vaping that's causing these illnesses?
It's a great question, George. A common misconception...
On the right side, right?
Just harmless
on the screen.
That's not true. In addition to nicotine, which is very addictive, these products emit heavy metals such as nickel, tin, and lead, harmful chemicals like benzene, flavorings, which can do damage to the lungs when they're inhaled, and also ultrafine particles, which are very damaging to the heart and lungs. Bottom line, anyone who's using these is placing themselves at risk, and we don't even know the medium and long-term health effects.
So much risk, but you use the word epidemic. 1 in 4 kids, or teens, have tried these,
right,
this vaping. What can we do to reduce this risk, bring it down?
The most important thing, I think, is to educate people. So parents and teens, teachers, everyone needs to be aware of what's going on. And, you know, teens who use these need to understand that they're placing themselves at risk for lifelong tobacco addiction and potentially serious lung damage. We encourage all parents to talk with their kids. Middle schoolers are using these, high schoolers are using these, and in occasional cases, elementary school. So definitely talk to your teens, maybe younger. Parents who are interested in learning more can go to the American Lung Association website. There's something called the Vape Talk. It's a conversation starter that will help them see what to ask their kids to get the conversation started, and schools can find resources there too if they want to start educating the kids.
That talking on is really important. Thank you for coming in this morning. Let's go to Cecilia.
Are you going to sit here?
The latest on Janet Jackson.
No, it's not that.
Superstar. She's been speaking out in a candid new interview about what it's like being a single mom caring for her 2-year-old son.
There she is.
Absolutely. I'm really excited to get the story. Big fan of Janet Jackson right here.
Didn't get it, right?
She said for a while she stayed away from watching any of her music videos, but just recently started watching again, getting into her son. The 53-year-old opening up about balancing motherhood and music, sharing a glimpse into life with 2-year-old son Issa Almana in a rare interview with Australia's Stellar magazine. She says, "It is hard being a working mother. I don't have a nanny. I do it all myself. If my mother did it with 9 children, there's no reason I can't. Of course, when I'm working, someone watches him, but it's my baby and me." The Grammy winner always thinking about her baby, revealing how her life on stage has changed after birth. "We used to rehearse 8 hours plus. That's down to maybe 4 hours. I really have to work harder, given the fact I don't rehearse as long, because I don't want to be away from my son." Janet and ex Issa Almana welcomed son Issa in 2017. The couple, who privately wed in 2012, then split in April of 2017.
Miss Janet Jackson.
And in March, during her acceptance speech for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, Jackson thanking her son.
"You are my heart, you are my life, and you have shown me the meaning of real unconditional love."
And although Jackson stepped into the spotlight at a young age when asked about her son following in her footsteps, she says, "It's really up to him. I wouldn't want him to do this from such a young age. You really have to be thick-skinned for this. You can really go in the wrong direction. There's so much temptation, all kinds of crazy things." Even though Janet says she's cautious about having her son start too early in the entertainment business, she says after watching him take a drumstick and a guitar and make believe it was a violin. She bought him one, and she says he is always with it. She says he sleeps with it, he eats with it. He is constantly with the violin, and she says he has perfect pitch.
I mean, it's in the genes of that family,
exactly,
for sure.
Exactly. It's great to hear from her. You don't really hear from her very often like that, so this was fun.
Yeah.
Okay, we're going to turn over to Ginger.